Hey there everyone, Hitesh here and welcome to Building Your Own SaaS video series. Hope you're enjoying this. If you're enjoying it, it would be really, it will mean a lot to me if you can just click a photo, post it on Twitter, tag me up, or post a photo on LinkedIn and tag me up. It will show your progress as well that, hey, you are serious and you are learning something, and it will mean a world to me. Anyways, if you're new here, subscribe and let's go ahead and move forward what we're gonna do next. This one is going to be a comparatively shorter video, and we just want to see how we can upload the videos. And again, we'll be just hitting the upload API, but I would just want to show you how the structure and everything works. The UI part, of course, we're gonna be just saving some time on that. I'll save your time, very valuable time. But in this one, let's just go ahead and get started with this one. So we can just go ahead and close these pages. We already have a page known as video upload page.js, and this is a video upload page. Whatever you want to call them, you can just go ahead and call that. Now, this time, let's go ahead and use Axios. We can use Fetch as well, but I want to show you more ways of so that you have more variety of the things that you can go ahead and try out. Again, there is no harm in using just one way, but I want to show, that's why tutorial exists. It shows you the variety. Let's just go ahead and say we want to go ahead and npm install and Axios. It's a really nice library, a nice way of doing a lot of things. We'll be using this one just for some additional stuff, just for fun. And again, we'll be needing the state as well. So let's just go ahead and say use state. Yep, that's the one. And since we're here, let's go ahead and say import Axios. Axios from Axios. And we'll be needing router as well. And router will come from the next navigation. So this one will be use router, and this will be navigation, not the React Next router. We'll be needing the navigation one. All right, navigation one, just because once the upload is done, we'll be redirecting them onto the home page and whatnot. All right, first of all, let's set up a couple of states so that we can have an idea what's going on and what's not going on. The most important for us is to have an access to the file, because we'll be doing a lot of things based on just the file. All right, so we'll be saying that, hey, this one is going to be null by default. We can actually mention the type of the file as well, that what kind of data we are expecting. Not required, but still, I can just go ahead and say this one is going to be either a file or it can be null. Again, optional since we are in the TypeScript. We'll be needing a couple of more parameters in case you forgot that. In our application, we are uploading title, description, and the file. So let's just create a state for that as well. We'll be needing a title. So we'll be needing set title just like this. We'll be needing description, const description, and set description just like that. Now we need a hint that whether things are getting uploaded or they have already done. So we'll be saying this one will be is uploading. And this one is going to be set uploading. Initially, it's going to be false. Since we're here, let's go ahead and create a router as well. Yeah, thank you so much for that. Probably they are listening to me as well now. I would also like to create a max file size as well. So I'll say max file size of how much? 70 MB would be good. 60 MB, 70 MB, 70 MB. MB, there we go. Come on, I need to fix this. Okay, so we'll be creating a variable for this one. So const max file size, and this is where it fails you. And it's not failing me, but the intention was just to have 70 MB. All right, good enough. That is all what we need. Now let's see that how we're going to handle the submit form. So a React form will be submitted, and this is how the form looks like. Upload video will be a form, and we need to handle all the data. So let's call this one as handle submit, const handle submit, and there we go, async. Ah, that's nice. Let's have an async event just like this. All right. So we can actually put this, what kind of event that will be. That will be a React form event. That would be even nice to have suggestion. React dot form event. Again, TypeScript stuff. All right, so this is the form event that is coming up. And why are you having an issue? Type annotation can only be used in TypeScript files. This is JSX, we should be having TSX. Let's rename this. DSX. This should be okay now. Good enough consistency. Shouldn't have a JSX in the first place. Anyways, the step one is whenever the form is being submitted, let's go ahead and say this one is going to be prevent default. After that, let's check whether the file is there or not. If file is not there, and again, event. I'll probably shorten this down. I don't want event. I want e.preventDefault. If there is no file, we're going to go ahead and just return. I don't want to proceed without file. I also want to check whether the file is in the limit size or not. You can do more checks as well. If the file size is greater than, then we're going to put up an alert. And we should also return like this. But again, alert is not a good idea to have in this place. But I'll keep a to-do for you. Add notifications. So that you can provide a notification. Alert is never a good idea because it stops all the execution that is happening. You cannot redirect anyone. Yeah, a lot of stuff can happen. Now let's see what we want to do and how we want to proceed. Now I want to handle the form data. So how I'm going to do this? I'll first enable that, hey, things are uploading, so don't do anything. Based on this, I can make my button gray out or something. But once this is all happening, collect all information from the form data, get a try catch, send the data to the API, and that's it. Let's start there. So first of all, set is uploading to true. Then let's collect all the information from the form. So we're going to go ahead and say const. Oh, nice. Form data. We'll be handling the file title and description. But we have more information because this is file uploading. File uploading means we will be talking to the Prisma and we need all this information. So ID automatically will be handled. Title description, that's okay. Public ID, we will be able to manage it. Original size, we have to manage. Compressed size will be given to us by Cloudinary. Duration will be given to us by the Cloudinary as well. But I think we can handle the original size just right up here. So let's just go ahead and say that form data, go ahead and use an append and we'll be giving an original size just like this. And we can grab it from file.size. So this is nice in case you were worried about it. The same file can give you the size as well, whatever the document, doesn't really matter if it is a video or anything else. Once this is all done, I know that I have my form data and file and all these stuffs. Let's go ahead and try to upload this first. Try catch would be nice. So have a try catch and let's try to send it. So we're going to say await and we'll be using Axios. So Axios has an inbuilt method of post. We'll be having API, which is video upload. Is it video upload? Yep, it is video upload. So we can just go ahead and have this, send a form data just with it, that's it. That is all what we need. And we can say response, just like this. Now, once we are done with this, we can go ahead and check whether the response is 200 or not. You can do all kind of stuff, but I think that is good enough. The video is getting uploaded, form data is there, all is good. So once this is all done, we need to handle more stuff. Check for 200 response. And this one is for you. Yeah. And in the catch part, we're going to go ahead and just do a console log error. That's it. And after that, I can just go ahead and use a finally. And inside the finally, I can just go ahead and set is uploading false. All right, my uploading is done. I'm not done with all of the tasks because this is the part where the file upload is being done. All right. So I have the title, description, all these things is hitting with taking all of this data to this API. And once this API is being hit, I come here, take in charge here. So I have all this information with me in the form data. And from the form data, I can have a request. Then we get the file, we get the title, we get the description, we get the original size, that's nice. Once this is all being done, we extract rest of the information and we send it to the Prisma as well as things are uploaded. We have the public ID and everything. Told you, it's super, super easy. Once this is all done, all we need to do is now build up a UI for this. All right, saving you some time on that part. So we have handled it nicely. And again, the most important part was this form. That is it, literally. It has a method of handle submit, which we just created. That's the logic part. The rest of our stuff is pretty simple. We have a label, then we have a simple input. This input says, hey, this is a title, value is title, text is text, that's it. We have controlled it by a state, classic React 101. By the way, I do have a React course as well, check that out. And then we have a description, we have a file upload, a basic file targets, and then we are having a submit, button is being controlled by the state. That's it, told you, it's really, really simple. Now that you know how to build the front end of the uploading or how to actually handle the image video upload part of it, now this is all being done. Now comes the interesting part where we design the card of the video, and we can use the Cloudinary, just like we use the cloud image, we will be using cloud video. And by the way, by the cloud video, I mean to say that, hey, this is the one. So this is what I call as cloud image. It's not really nice to call it as CLD image. I call it as cloud image or Cloudinary image. Similar to this, we'll be using this cloud video player. We can use player as well. So we'll be using this one to actually handle that. So that is what's going to come up in the handling of the video part. The next one, we need to design a cloud image, the cloud card. And once the cloud card is done, all we have to do is grab all the requests from the Prisma and just iterate and loop through it and display our component of the card. That's it. All right, so it's pretty good, pretty nice, and it's really late night. Let's go ahead and catch it up on tomorrow. Thank you so much, and hit that subscribe, and I'll catch you up tomorrow.